The swarms of Hive Fleet Kraken are sly. Their every instinct and action calculated towards outmaneuvering and encircling their prey. In this video, we'll be showing you how to batch paint your Termagants in the colours of Hive Fleet Kraken. Batch painting means painting a group of miniatures at the same time, which is great for larger units like Termagants. This means we'll be painting as efficiently as possible to get your hordes on the gaming table ready to devour your enemies in no time at all. For this video, we'll be painting three Termagants, but the techniques shown can be used over larger numbers of miniatures. These colours will work on any Tyranid in your collection that you want to paint in the Hive Fleet Kraken colour scheme. You'll have an army ready to go before you know it. If you're new to painting, you can check out the Citadel Colour Painting Essentials videos to learn all about it. The paints we've used are on screen now. Remember that we're painting in the colours of Hive Fleet Kraken, and you can paint your models however you like. Any additional equipment we've used is also on screen, but feel free to use whatever brushes you're most comfortable with. The first thing we need to do is undercoat the model, and for this colour scheme we've used Wraithbone. This is a nice warm undercoat to get us started on this scheme, and we'll be using contrast paint, which works really well over this colour. It's also a good idea to have a pot of Wraithbone to hand, just in case we need to do any tidy ups later. So we're going to start off by painting all of the flesh in Morghast bone. For this we'll be using a medium base brush, as we don't need to worry about being neat. This is a base paint, so we need to thin it down with some water and apply a couple of layers. Once you've put a layer of paint down on one miniature, move on to the next one while it's drying. When we're batch painting, we don't want to be waiting around for paint to dry. So while we're waiting for a stage to dry, move on to the next miniature. And once you've applied the paint to the final miniature in your group, in theory, the first one should be dry, ready for you to move on to the next stage. Batch painting can be used to paint as many miniatures as you want at once. You may want to just paint two at once, or you could paint a larger group. It's really up to you. Do whatever you feel is most achievable. Once all of that is dry, we're going to move on to applying a contrast paint over the flesh. For this, we'll be using Skeleton Horde, and we'll be applying this straight from the pot. When we're applying contrast paint, we need to apply it heavily and neatly, working in small sections. This ensures the paint doesn't dry too quickly anywhere, and it gives us maximum control while we're using it. Again, we don't need to worry about being neat here. The next colours will cover up any mistakes anyway. If you find that it is pooling too much in any of the recesses, clean off your brush and use that to soak up any excess. And as we're batch painting, while we're waiting for one miniature to dry, we can be moving on to the next one. And once that first layer of Skeleton Horde is dry, we're going to go in again just into some of the recessed detail. And for this, we'll be using a smaller brush. A medium layer brush works really well here. All we want to do with this is add it to the recessed detail, and this just gives us a little bit more depth and interest across the miniatures. Before you do this, just make sure that first layer is fully dry. If it's not quite dry, we could accidentally pull off some of that first layer and create unwanted texture on the model. And with that, our first two big stages are done, so we can move on to adding some extra detail. Now we're going to use Tyrant Skull to dry brush the entire miniature. And for this, we'll be using a small dry brush to help us get into all those tricky to reach areas. Tyrant Skull is a dry paint, so it's really good for this job. However, if you don't have this to hand, something like Screaming Skull would work really well too. When we're dry brushing, we just need to make sure that we remove as much paint off the brush as possible. We can remove this onto a paper towel or a piece of cardboard. Then we move the brush over the raised detail of the miniature. And what this does is it catches all that detail and creates a highlight. You want to start off with a soft layer and build it up on the miniature until you're happy with the level of highlight. It can be a little bit tricky to correct too much dry brushing, so take your time and build up those soft layers. When you're dry brushing, move the brush in forwards and backwards motions and also in circular motions. This will ensure we catch as much of that detail as possible. And we're doing this now so we don't have to worry about getting any of that dry brush onto any areas we're painting later. Now the flesh is all done, so we can move on to that distinctive red carapace. Now the next thing we're going to do is use Flesh Tearer's Red on that carapace. We're using a medium layer brush here, as we do want to be a little bit neater. We can always correct mistakes with the previous colours, but if we can avoid making them, it does save time in the long run. Again, we want to apply this contrast paint neatly and heavily in those small sections. Just be careful to control the paint and avoid it pooling too much in those recesses. We also want to make sure that there isn't any water on our brush before we dip into the pot. This is because it could dilute the paint and we won't get quite as strong a colour on the miniature. And you'll see that Flesh Terror's red is a really deep red, and as we're applying it over a really light undercoat, this means those natural highlights come through. Contrast paint is brilliant for efficiency, as it does all the shading and highlighting for us. This means we won't have to add any extra steps if we don't want to, and it'll still result in your models looking awesome on the tabletop. Now we're going to paint the hooves and the claws and also the weapon. For this, we'll be using black Templar and sticking with that medium layer brush. If you prefer, you could use a smaller brush. Apply just like your other contrast paints, being careful around those details we've already finished. Again, those natural highlights really show through under that black Templar, so it's a great choice for painting efficiently. And with that done, the largest stages of this guide are finished. With just a few extra details, your models will be ready to go on the tabletop and slay your enemies in no time. Now we're going to paint some grey areas using Celestra Grey. This is the tongue and the weapon pipe. We'll also be using this to paint any base detail, but you can pick that out in whatever colour you prefer. This is a base paint, so thin it down and apply a couple of layers. This will make sure we've got good coverage. Now we're going to paint the eye on the weapon and also the teeth in Wraithbone. We're repainting the eye in this colour because we're going to be using a contrast paint over it. And if we've got a nice pale base coat underneath that contrast paint, you'll see that those natural highlights really come through. We're now just going to drop some Iron Jaws yellow into the eyes of the Termagant, and this will give us a really menacing, glowy yellow eye effect. Now we'll paint the eye on the weapon, and for this we'll use Storm Fiend. Again, apply this heavily and neatly. We don't need to worry too much about being neat, as the blue will blend into the black really nicely. And if you clean off your brush and just use that to soak up the excess from the centre of the eye, you'll see that the paint pulls away from the middle, which creates even more of a natural highlight. And the final thing we're going to do is apply Norn Oil to the tongue and the mouth, as well as those weapon pipes. This will add some subtle depth without overpowering that base coat. Apply just like the contrast paint, being careful to avoid any excess pooling. And there we are, your Termagants are finished, ready to surge through gaps in enemy defences and savagely exploit their weaknesses. You can see that our model is based using Astrogranite debris, and if you'd like to learn more about technical paints, you can check out our video all about them. For more tutorials, tips and tricks, you can head to your local Warhammer store, where our amazing staff will be happy to help you. Or check out citadelcolour.com. Well, we hope you've enjoyed the video and we'll see you next time. Bye!